Hello, this is a small adjustable step-up boost converter I got from Banggood.com. I'm going to take it out and do some tests. The input voltage is between 3.5 and 32 volts and the output voltage between 5 and 35 volts. The output current is 2.5 amps, 3 if you add the heatsink. The output voltage can be adjusted using this potentiometer and it's regulated to 0.5%. This is a mini voltmeter I've connected to the output of the boost converter. The mini voltmeter goes up to 100 volts. I'm powering the boost converter using this buck converter, which I've also reviewed. And I'm measuring the output of the boost converter using this ammeter. Here I have a 1K resistor. This is a 100 ohm resistor, a 50 ohm resistor, and a series of two 10 ohm resistors. I'm going to start by setting the output voltage of the boost converter to 10 volts. You can see that even if it's not connected to a load, it draws 15 milliamps. I'm connecting it to the 1K load and it draws 10 milliamps. It has 10 milliamps on the output, but it draws 36. The 100 ohms. You can see the voltage is pretty stable. 50 ohms. . 20 ohms. And let's try 10 ohms. And again, pretty stable. Raising the output. And let's go through the same sequence. 1K, 100 ohms, 50 ohms, 20 ohms, and I need to raise the limits of my source. Let's set it to the 6 amps maximum. Let's go again, 20 ohms. The voltage on the boost converter seems to drop. And my resistors are smoking. Let's try the 10 ohms. These are 10 1 ohm 5 watt resistors. I've set the output of the boost converter to 10 ohms. Because the wires that I am passing the current through are 2 ohms, I'm going to only connect 8 of the resistors and we should get 1 amp, and we do. And we're drawing 2.6 amps from the boost converter, from the buck converter. I've set the boost converter to 20 volts, but I had to raise the buck converter to 10 volts so that it can supply the required current that the boost converter requires to get 2 amps out when I connect this 10 ohm load. And we should get 2 amps, and we do. We're drawing a bit over 5 amps from the power supply in order to output 2 amps at 20 volts. We have 10 volts and 5 amps on the input, which gives a 50 watts of power. And on the output we have 20 volts with 2 amps, which is 40 watts. At these settings, we get a conversion efficiency of around 80%. But if we connect a 100 ohm load, we have 10 volts on the input with 450 milliamps, which is 4.5 watts of power. On the output, we have 20 volts with 200 milliamps, which is 4 watts of power, giving us a conversion efficiency of around 89%. I'm using this bulb because my resistors can't handle the power output. I've set the voltage on the buck converter to 5 volts. And the voltage on the output of the boost converter is 35 volts. If we measure the input current is 630 milliamps. With 5 volts that gives us 3.15 watts. And on the output we have 35 volts and 75 milliamps, which is 2.6 watts. That gives us a conversion efficiency of 83%. These types of boost converters are very useful on projects where you have limited space or you need portability. Here, for example, I'm powering this 12 volts fan from a single lithium cell. The cell outputs 3.8 volts. And the boost converter gives out 12 volts. Again, I'm measuring the current here at 100 milliamps. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of these kinds of videos, subscribe to my channel.